Hey everyone, Camtasia 2023 was just released today and it came out with a whole slew of new features. We're gonna talk about each feature throughout the next couple of different videos that I produce here, but today we're gonna focus mostly on an exciting feature, which is motion paths. So let's go ahead and get started. Welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt. And if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering everything learning development related, anything storyline, X API, different templates that you can use for learning development, all those different kinds of things. You can also download free templates, Articulate Storyline 360 templates, X API and video templates, PDF templates as well. And if any of these topics are new to you, you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. But in today's video, we're gonna talk specifically about the 2023 release of Camtasia. Now, it just came out today, the same day that this video is being released here, and it has a lot of important updates, and probably the one that I'm most excited about is motion paths. You can now go in and create curves and different points inside of a motion path. Now with Camtasia, you could always create different types of animations and movements from point A to point B, but you can get a lot more detailed now, and we're gonna explore different possibilities here. So to create an example here, I'm gonna go ahead and download some pictures at freepik.com. So if you go to freepik.com, you can download a lot of different types of pictures, images, videos, and so forth. I'm gonna go into the vector section and we're gonna download a vector here. And I'm gonna search for, within the vectors, I'm gonna search for an office. Now there's different types of offices that you'll get. Now these are all Illustrator files, so you can download them and open them up inside of Illustrator or whatever vector tool that you may be using. I like this one right here, so I'm gonna go ahead and click on that one here. Now this website is awesome, but you do have to keep in mind anything if it says free license or how is the attribution, if you need to reference the author or something like that. So keep that in mind, make sure that you go in there and check that out. Otherwise, you can go ahead and just click on download. I'm gonna select this drop-down box and it's gonna give me the different types of downloads that I can do. If I only need a JPEG, I can download a JPEG. If I need the Illustrator file, AI, Adobe Illustrator, if I need that file or the EPS file, which is more compatible with other vector tools like Sketch or other tools like that, basically. I'm gonna go ahead and download the AI file here and it's going to download it to my desktop here. I already have Adobe Illustrator pulled up and we're really not going to do much here. So I'm just gonna basically take this file and I'm going to open it up with Adobe Illustrator. So let's hit close here and I'm gonna hit skip and I'm gonna close out some of the extra windows that I had pulled up here. Zoom in a little bit and you can see I can go in and I can adjust the images, the colors of all that. Or if I just hit Control A or Command A and then Control C or Command C, I can then copy that and let's go into Camtasia 2023 here. Now Camtasia 2023, I've already started a new project. If you don't see this, you basically click on new project right here and it will come up with your new project. Now I'm just gonna hit Control V and it's gonna paste that image right there. All right, so let's go ahead and resize this. I zoomed out a little bit with my mouse scroll and I'm gonna go ahead and resize this so it fits the entire screen here. Because it's vector, it's going to keep it as a vector image, so we're not gonna get any pixelization. And I just wanna make sure that I fill the entire screen. So I think that looks great. Now, what I wanna do is have some type of person inside of my Camtasia file here, and I wanna animate that person along the motion path. Now, there's a lot of different ways that you can create these different types of people, but one of the ways that I've found recently is inside of PowerPoint. So if you go into PowerPoint Mac or a PC, and inside of PowerPoint, what you can do is you can get an add-in. So if you go into Insert here, I'm gonna click on Got It here, but if you go into Insert, and then you go into Add-ins, for a Mac, it will pop open a browser, but for Windows, it will actually pop open a window right inside of Windows there. Now you can then search for an add-in called Pixton. So P-I-X-T-O-N. And there's this Pixton comic characters. If I click on that and click on get it now, it's going to install a plugin to my PowerPoint. Now I already have that plugin installed. So if I go back to the home screen, this is where it will install this add-in basically. If I click on that, I can create an animated character with different poses, and then I can copy and paste those inside of Camtasia, which is exactly what I want to do. I want to have a character that's moving. I could have a character that changes different poses, different things like that. So I'm going to go ahead and click on get started here. And so let's try to find one. You could try to find one that's more similar to you. I'm going to go ahead and choose one right here. And then I'm going to choose kind of my hair color. I'd say more darker brown there, kind of short haircut there, not a high top. So trying to find an image that looks close to me here. Let's go ahead and choose this one here. So once I've chosen the character, now I have the different poses here. So let's start out with just kind of a standard pose, walking in the office. So I'm just gonna grab this pose right here, kind of just standing in the office there. Now you can also just select that person and hit Control C. Let's go into Camtasia 2023 and then hit Control V. Now I can resize that, make him a lot larger there. And there we go. Now my goal here is to make him a little bit smaller, like he's further behind, and then have him walk up there. You could do this already with Camtasia in a certain way. And I'm gonna show you the difference between what you could do before in Camtasia 2022 and earlier, and what you could do now with these motion paths. So I'm gonna take this person right here. And so let's go ahead and zoom in on our timeline. And I'm gonna stretch this out a little bit longer here. Let's stretch it out to almost that 16, 15 mark there. And so what I'm going to do here is go into my animations. And then in my animations, I could always do like this custom pathway. So I could have the character go from point A to point B. So you can see here, they just go and it's a direct line, basically. There's no curve or anything like that. It's just a direct line. Well, in the case of this person, we don't always walk in direct lines as a person. At least I don't. Maybe I'm just all over the place, but that doesn't always work. So there may be some things where you want to have like a bird fly in a certain motion path or anything like that. That's where these motion paths come into play. So let's go ahead and remove that animation real quick. And I'm going to add this new motion path animations. So in the motion path, I could just drag and drop it to a clip that I want. Now it looks a little bit different than that arrow, the point A to point B, but it works almost identical as far as we're gonna animate it from here to there, basically. So we'll find that out here. So right here, here's my motion path. And over on the right-hand side, anytime you have like an animation or any type of effect inside of Camtasia, the properties of that effect are always on the right-hand side in that panel here. So you can see right here, if I'm done editing and click on finish editing, I can adjust the type of line, which we'll come back to as well. I can adjust the type of easing if it slows down at the end or if it slows down at the beginning, I can do that type of thing as well. And then there's a auto orient, which we'll talk about later as well. So coming back into my motion path, if I select this little drop down, this little arrow here, you'll notice it has the motion path for the entire clip, but this is really when the motion path is going to happen. So notice how it goes from the point A, and then we have a curved line here, all the way over to point B. Now we have some handlebars right here. So we have a handlebar right here, and we have a handlebar right there. What those handlebars do is they allow me to adjust the angle of that motion path. That motion path is not gonna go in a straight line, it's gonna curve. And so we can adjust how that curve happens here. So I can click this and adjust, okay, I don't want it to be as much of a curve at the beginning, or let's say we want a big curve at the end, I can select that and drag that out, and you can see how we get that big curve at the end there. So that's how you can kind of adjust that and go up and down, sideways and so forth to adjust the type of curve that happens. I can also adjust the length of the curve by going down to the timeline and stretching point B. I always call this point A and this point B, but stretching point B out to adjust the length of time. How long will this actually take to go from point A to point B? So here we go. It's going to go along the curve, but that doesn't look realistic because now the person is, you know, floating above me there or above the floor basically. So I'm gonna take point B and I'm gonna just adjust it down here. Now I do want the person to kind of curve along the pathway and come over here. Let's go ahead and adjust the handlebars a little bit and just make it not as big of a curve there. So you can see here, I'm over here and I'm gonna move over there. One thing I may also wanna do is adjust the size of the person. Maybe they're a little bit smaller as they're further away and then they get bigger. I can adjust the scale here, but notice how it does not adjust the scale, or it keeps that same scale when I get to point B. So you kind of have to add on the old way of animating along with the motion path if you're trying to do something in addition to the motion path. What I'm gonna do here is I'm going to go back to point A and I'm gonna take my custom animation, drag it down here to kind of the same length as my motion path here. And I'm gonna go back to point A, select that dot on point A and adjust the scale here. Now, once I do that, notice how the scale starts to get a little bit bigger. And I even want it to be even more drastic. So let's go ahead and adjust this up to like 700. Now I can see, okay, it's a little bit smaller. The guy's back there and he starts to walk up here and get a little bit bigger. In combination of the old way of animating, that's what changes from point A to point B, I can also add on the motion paths and have that curve and adjustment along the curve basically as well. Now, just like with other motion paths and other tools, you can also add on other points. So if I actually take my cursor here and I move this and right click in the middle, and I move this to the middle here, and then I right click, I have this add motion path point at playhead. So this, if you're not familiar with that, this is actually, this little line right here is called the playhead. That allows me to take my playhead and move it to any point at the time of my animation. And what you see on the stage here is exactly what is going to be visible at that point of time. So that's really what that playhead is. So I'm gonna just right click on this again. I'm gonna go to add path point at playhead. And then now it gives me this extra dot. What this extra dot does is allows me to adjust the curve even more. So now I can have this extra point where they come down to here first and then they go over there. Now I do have these two handlebars over here that I could just click and stretch, and you can see how it adjusts that curve. If you want to even get like a drastic angle, like a right angle or something like that, hold down the Alt or Option key, Option if you're on a Mac or Alt on a PC, and you'll notice how you can then even angle it even more and adjust one of them instead of adjusting both of them. So that is one way to, if you just want to adjust the angle for one of them, you could just hold down Option or Alt. So a nice way to be able to just control these motion paths a little bit more. So an awesome tool to be able to create these more custom animations inside of Camtasia. There's just a lot of potential here. I'm gonna just go ahead and bring in something else here. So you can see I brought in just, I went to iconduck.com and I downloaded a picture of a bird here. I know there's usually not birds in offices, but just work with me here. Maybe you'd wanna have like in a park or like an outside landscape or something like that. But I don't wanna take the time to recreate everything right now just to show you this one thing. I'm gonna drag this bird here and I'm gonna kind of zoom in, move over a little bit, and I'm gonna take this bird and I'm going to move that bird over. So let's come back to our pointer here, stretch that back out. And then I'm gonna take that bird and move it over. So what I'm going to do is I want the bird to face the other way. So I'm gonna go over to my Y value and just change that to 180. Now that I've changed it to 180, it's now facing this way. And you'll see why here in a second. But we're gonna go ahead and add a motion path to that. Now that motion path is what is going to fly in and fly out, but along a curve. So I'm gonna take point B, and I want it to fly kind of out of the screen there. And I'm gonna adjust so the curve is a lot bigger. So I'm gonna adjust it to kind of fly up and then down right there. So there you can see the motion path and the bird flies in and flies out there. Now, here is one of the nice features about motion paths. A couple nice features is not only can you change it from the right angles and you can adjust kind of what we talked about with the Alt key, but you can also adjust easing in and easing out. Easing in is like it starts out slow and then easing out will actually finish slow. So ease in, so think of in as in start, and then out as in stop. And so ease in means that it's easing at the start. Ease out is it's easing at the end. So just to keep in mind in and out, I don't know why it's in and out specifically, but just at the very beginning and at the very end. Or if you want it to ease both, you can do that as well. But here's what I'm trying to get at is the auto orient. So now if I select that, watch how the bird will actually face forward and adjust its angle based on the curvature of the motion path. So you can see that it will adjust out. Now, the motion, it will do it based off of the top right-hand side, so you could probably adjust that a little bit, but you can see how it will adjust and orient the object based off of that. Because if I uncheck that, notice how it kind of stays the same, no matter the curvature, basically. So I'm gonna click on auto orient again, and we get a little bit more of a natural kind of curve there. Maybe not so much with the way that the wings are set in that bird image, but you get the point there of being able to orient the object that you have along the path. And we're just really scratching the surface here of what you can do with Camtasia 2023. So I'm gonna be making a lot more videos. Make sure you head on over to my YouTube channel. You click that like button, it really helps out my video. You also subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification so you're alerted of all new videos as they come out. And then make a comment of other videos that you wanna see as well. But you'll also see, if you're subscribed, you'll see all of the new Camtasia videos as they come out. So that's all I have for today. Thanks everyone. I'll see you next time.